it as soon as we can.
Sure. Okay, today's section is a continuation of last day portion, right? So,
did you revise, Vedanti? Did you revise last day portions?
Okay, good. Then you consent, we can wait for 2 minutes. What about Sayali? Sorry, Kritika.
So first one is Lewis acid and base. Lewis acid and base. This is our topic. Okay. Hello, Shana. Can you hear me? Hello. Shana, can you hear me? Okay. Today, we want to study the concept that is Lewis acid and base. Lewis acid and base. Okay. Then, what do you mean by Lewis acid? It is defined as an acid. Okay. A species which accepts electron pair. Lewis acid is very, very important concept. Lewis acid means it has a tendency to accept electron pair. This is called Lewis acid. And Lewis base means what? Donate electron pair. This is called what? Lewis acid and Lewis base respectively. Okay. Then we can go through some example. Look, students. In the case of BF3, boron trifluoride, okay, it will react with NH3, okay, boron trifluoride reacted with NH3. Here you can see that BF3 is a one of the electron deficient species, okay. So, it has a tendency, it is an electron deficient species, so that it has a tendency to accept electron from NH, having a lone pair concept. Na? So it can easily accept electron pairs from nitrogen. As a result, it forming bonds. So that here BF3 will act as a Lewis acid, is Lewis acid, and this one is Lewis base. These are the concept, Lewis acid and Lewis base. Okay, like AlCl3, CO3 plus Mg plus 2, these are electron deficient species. Look, student, Mg plus 2 is electron, 2 electron is deficient here. Okay, so calcium plus 2, AlCl3. These are mainly electron deficient species. Okay. Yeah, especially AlCl3 like. Boron BF3, Anna students, we can check its electron deficiency. Actually, 3 fluorine surrounded by boron. Boron have a electron configuration. What about atomic number of boron? Boron is 5. So 2, 3 like this. So 3. Look, suppose for getting octet, how much electron is present in the valence shell? Varun, is 2 plus 2 plus 2 equal to 6? 6 electrons only, 6 electronic species. So it wants 2 more electrons for more getting stability. So these type of things, from this conclusion, we can say that boron is an electron deficient type species. It is only a 6 electron only in it. Okay, so BF3 is boron deficient. So for balancing, for the balancing of that NH3, N is ready to donate electron towards BF3. So this is the concept of Lewis acid, Lewis base setup.
We want to identify. Okay, I will ready to give some example. You want to identify.
What are Lewis acid, Lewis base? Okay,
I will give.
Suppose HO minus, F minus, HO plus, BCl3. Can you classify it into Lewis acid and then Lewis base format? Classify here. Tell, this is for you. Do it fast. Tell me, out of 4, what are Lewis acid students? Text me. If texting problem, I will number 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. Okay. Then tell me, what are under the category of Lewis acid? Tell me.
Shaunak, text me Shaunak.
Lewis acid H plus, right? Then Lewis base. OH minus, right? You are telling Lewis acid H plus, Lewis base OH minus. Then this much only? Acid BCl3, right? Base remaining. Correct, you are right. Okay, why? Because this negative charge, so we can conclude these are base. It will act as a base. And an acid, H plus is an acid, BCl3 is also acid, because boron, and boron is electron deficient in nature. Boron related BCl3, BF3, BBr3, everything is, we can conclude that boron is an electron deficient. So it will attract electron from other species. So it is act as a Lewis acid, boron related. Okay, right, you are right.
Then next, concept related to that, ionization of acid and base. Ionization of acid and base. Ionization of acid and base.
Here, acid and base is going to ionize, students. Okay.
So you know the ionization of acid. Suppose HCl is going to dissociation, it become H plus plus Cl minus, forming ions. After dissociation, it will forming ions type. That okay. Then suppose any acid is mixed with HA is our acid. HA is our acid.
Here H2O water is act as a base. Then can you guess what about the product? It will form H3O plus plus.
Okay. Water is conjugated acid and A minus is a conjugated base. Understood.
Here H plus plus A minus. Here H2O completely it is acid. This one is our base. So this base and acid combined together. What happened? This H plus ion is combined together with water molecule in specially for acid. Then it is accept proton. Okay. What conjugate Lewis acid, Lewis base we already discussed. Bronsted acid, Bronsted base is discussed. Arrhenius acid, Arrhenius base is discussed. So Arrhenius concept, we can say that one is conjugated acid, conjugate. So here acid. Okay, here is the conjugate base. Here conjugate acid. Conjugate acid of this one. Because this is a base. Understood? HA is acid. It's a simple representation. HCl. A represented by Cl. That much only. Means symbolic representation, that much only, is an example only, is not a pure acid. But this is the condition when acid is reacted with the water. Water is now here, it is act as a base. Okay, then it will convert it into conjugate acid. Conjugate acid means what? HA. When conjugate acid means after the it can donate proton. Okay, conjugate acid have a tendency to donate proton forming base. So H3O plus H3O plus na, here we can remove a proton and forming H plus and H2O and H plus current. So water is regaining. Na. That's why it is act as a conjugate, having the tendency to donate electron. This is proton, sorry. Donate proton. Okay. So after the donation of proton, it will get a base. Then again, it has a tendency to accept a proton. Okay. So that A minus accept H plus with to form HA. So this is the acid corresponding to conjugate base is this one. This is base is corresponding conjugate acid is this one. Clear this much? Any doubt, Shaunak? Okay. This is a conjugated acid base concept. Then, stronger. One more point wise you want to just note down. Okay. Here, stronger acid donate a proton to stronger base. This is another concept. This also over. Next, I am telling some conceptual knowledge you want to note down. Stronger acid donate a proton to stronger base. This concept you want to memorize. Stronger acid can donate a proton to stronger base. These are the things. Stronger acid can donate a proton to the stronger base. This is the theory actually. So point wise you want to memorize. Okay. Stronger acid have a very weak conjugate base. Stronger acid have a very weak conjugate base. We can go through some example. Okay. These two concepts is very important. Okay. First, stronger acid can donate a proton to the stronger base. Second one, stronger acid have a very weak conjugate base. Suppose HClO4 minus O4. HClO4 and This is an example, HClO4. This HClO4 is strong acid. It's called perchloric acid. What is this? Perchloric acid. This is called a perchloric acid, stronger acid, perchloric acid. Then HCl, another hydrochloric acid. HCl is very strong. HBr also another strong acid. Okay, these are the stronger acid category. Okay, nitric acid, sulfuric acid, everything you know, students. HNO3, nitric acid stronger. H2SO4 is also very, very stronger. Okay, HNO3, H2SO4, these are stronger acid. Okay, then it will give a conjugate base of ion. Can you tell conjugate base of this one? This. Can you first HClO4, conjugate base? Can you tell? How we will find out conjugate base? Very easy. Refer last portion. Means we can eliminate some proton, we will get a conjugate base. Understood, Shonak? Okay, then tell me what about the conjugate base of HClO4. One day, I will help you for first question. You can eliminate a proton. So remaining product ClO4 minus. This is called your conjugate base. This is your conjugate base. Then can you predict remaining, Shonak? What about HCl? Tell me. What about HCl? Correct. Cl minus. Then what about this is Br minus. This one. Tell me HNO3. HNO3. Correct. NO3 minus. Then here H2SO4. Yes, so HSO4 minus, like this. Okay. HSO4 minus, NO3 minus. These are much weaker base than H2O. These are base actually. Cl, Cl minus, Br minus, NO3, HSO4. These are weaker base. Weaker base than H2O. Understood? So this is the thing. That's why stronger acid having weak conjugate base. Clear? Cl minus, F minus, NO3 minus are conjugate base of stronger acid like HCl, HBr, HNO3. So now the concept is matching. Look, stronger acid have a very weak conjugate base. Clear, students? Stronger acid have a very weak conjugate base. Clear, Shonak? Okay. Then, suppose strong acid have a very weak conjugate base. Then, another statement, weak acid have a very strong, weak acid have a very strong conjugate. Tell me dash, conjugate just opposite. Here we stronger acid have a very weak conjugate base. So weak acid have a very strong conjugate. Conjugate. Acid base concept, na? If we have a weak acid, have a very strong conjugate. Tell me, Shona, it's very easy. Conjugate dash base, correct.
conjugate base.
Simple only, this is a concept. If you remember one thing,
it can apply by yourself. Because during examination, you can expect a type of question, na?
They will give a stronger acid.
Okay,
and then you want to tell me what about the nature of conjugate bases, strong or weak. Definitely you can say that if they are given is given one is a strong acid, definitely it should have a very weak conjugate base. So you want to check it's weak or strong. In option you can see weak, strong and neutral, like that. So you want to identify what type of thing is like that. Suppose they are given providing weak acid like acetic acid. Suppose we can check CH3COOH, this acetic acid is very weak acid. Okay, then it having H plus, having a CH3COO minus, this one is called it's a conjugate base. This is acetate ion is very strong. Very strong. Weak acid, acetic acid is weak acid. After that, it forming a conjugate base, that is CH3COO minus, is very strong. Like this. Acetate ion. Clear?
Okay. Are you okay? Shonak? Okay. We can move on to next. Next, tell me, suppose
H2O is an acid.
Okay, H2O is an our acid.
Again, we have a possibility water can act as both acid as well as base. Another base form, just imagine two molecules of water combined together.
Okay, so what are the conjugated acid? What about the conjugated acid and what about the conjugated base?
Can you tell what about the conjugated acid? Tell me formula of conjugated acid, then conjugated base. Tell me.
Water. So conjugated base should be? Tell.
Conjugated acid.
How it will form? Conjugated acid means addition of proton. Right. Removal of proton from the area, we will get a conjugated base. We can say like that in short manner.
Then tell.
What are the condition of acid base? Conjugated acid and conjugated base.
Conjugated base is OH minus, right?
Then what about conjugated acid? Very good.
H3O plus, right? Okay. So this is the water. If we add one more proton, we will get H3O plus as conjugated acid. Here it will act as a conjugate base. That much only.
Very good. Okay. So these are the things. Then we are going to forming a dissociation constant K.
You know that product divided by reactant. Am I right?
So we already in the beginning of kinetics, equilibrium, we can discuss through that kind of points. Dissociation constant is represented by
product concentration.
What about the product? These are the product concentration of H3O plus into concentration of OH minus upon concentration of H2 as the concentration. This is called reaction constant, means dissociation constant is represented by like this. Okay, here what we can do now, here concentration of water is omitted. Concentration of water we can omit it, so that we will get a new constant, that is Kw. Kw, we can omit the concentration of water because water concentration we can't represent. So we will avoid that concentration and forming a new term that is called Kw. This is called ionic product of water. Kw is called what? Kw is equal to ionic product of water. We will get ionic product of water. This is called ionic product of water. Kw is equal to concentration of H3O plus into concentration of OH minus. We will get ionic product of water. Okay. Then, concentration of H plus N, it has been found out experimentally as 1 into 10 to the power minus 7. 1 into 10 to the power minus H plus. Okay. Look, students, we already know that suppose anything water is going to dissociate, during dissociation we know that equal number of positive and negative will form. Why? Because positive added with negative, it going to canceling, forming a neutral species like this. Actually, suppose summation, left hand side is equal to right hand side charges. Okay, so right hand side should be neutral, then only left hand side should be neutral. Here we can see the positive charge, again negative charge. Positive negative is going to is total, is summation, total summation of charge in this side is neutral. Here also already we can, there is no charge, both are neutral. So that we can conclude that H plus, here H plus ion is forming now. Actually H3O plus ka meaning kya hai? H plus plus H2O, H2O pe one a proton is added. So we will get, so H plus constant, H plus form is H plus is equivalent to OH minus in the right hand side. Then only this condition become satisfied. So H plus is equal to OH minus. That's why I already 1.0 into 10 to the power of minus 7 is the moles per liter. This is the concentration. This is the concentration of H plus ion. Okay, it has been experimentally proved. Okay, concentration of H in square bracket H plus is the concentration. Na? So 1 into 10 to the power minus 7 molar. Here also say because both are equal and shown. Na? So can you tell me 1 into 10 to the power minus 7 the whole square molar. This is the entire concentration of both. Both concentration, that is equal to what about the ratio of 1 into 10 to the power minus 14 molar. This is the ionic product of water. We consider an ion or molar square also, hai na? Molar square also. Mole also you want to square up karo. So here we will get ionic product of Kw. In the case of Kw, what we will get? Ionic product of water. Ionic product of water, here we can consider it as an H plus ion concentration. Here OH minus as say, as such as, then 1 H plus ion equal to 1 into 10 to the power minus 7 molar. So if we calculated it with its power, we will get Kw, ionic product of water is 1 into 10 to the power minus 7 molar whole square. We will get, because both are same and both are equal. That's why. So we will get the result 1 into 10 to the power minus 14 mole square. Clear? So Kw is equal to that much. This much understood? Shonak? Okay. 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 Then next, here acidicity, we are define acidic, neutral, basic. How we can acidic, neutral, basic? Acidic na is very, you can note down. Okay. Acidic means if H2O, H3O plus concentration, H3O plus concentration or H plus concentration, it is higher than OH minus concentration, we can say it is acidic in nature. Then basic. OH minus concentration is greater than H3O plus concentration, so it is called basic. And then neutral. Neutral means what? If H3O plus concentration is equivalent to OH minus concentration, we will call it as neutral. Study this one, it's very important. Acid means if OH minus ion concentration is higher than, H3O plus ion concentration is higher than OH minus. Here OH minus is higher, here H3O plus and OH minus are equal. So we will call it as a neutral acid base respectively. Okay, one more thing, students. Suppose our density of pure water, density. How we will define density? Density equal to, tell me, a formula is there, for density finding. What is that? Density is equivalent to, can you tell me, Shauna, density equivalent to mass by volume, right? Okay, density is equal to mass by volume. Here density unit mass in kilogram we can represent, no issue, kilogram. Then volume is meter cube or centimeter cube. So kilogram per meter cube, gram, kilogram or gram per meter cube or kilogram, no problem. Meter cube, gram per meter cube or kilogram per meter cube, kilogram. So volume, we can represent like this. It is in the unit wise, okay. Then means gram per volume, okay, meter cube, not volume is in liter, so gram per liter, that also is unit, gram per liter. Suppose our water have 1000 gram per liter is the density of water, okay. Density of water is equal to 1000 gram per liter. Then its molar mass also we know that. Density, molar mass is equal to 18 gram per mole. 18 gram per mole is the molar mass of water, 18 gram per mole. Then after that we know that molar density, mass by volume, and then formula, molarity of pure water, molarity, we can define by this 1000 gram per liter divided by 18 gram per mole. Gram cancel, so 1000 upon 18. What about the result? Any idea? Can you do?
anyway 55.55 mole per liter, moles per liter. 55.55 molar or moles per liter or molarity, capital letter M, we can represent it like that also.
Okay, capital letter. This is also another thing. The next one is pH scale. What is that? pH scale. So acid or base, na, which one is acid, which one is base, we can identify with the help of a famous scale that is called pH scale. This is called a definition means potential of hydrogen, H plus ion concentration, hydrogen, H plus hydrogen. This is called potential of, this is the pH definition. Means 55.5555. Correct. Right. So these are the things, student. Then the hydronium ion pH scale. Next point is called what? pH scale. Hydronium ion concentration in molarity is more conveniently expressed on a logarithmic scale is called what? pH scale. Hydronium ion concentration means H plus ion concentration can represent it in a scale. That is called pH scale. Hydronium ion concentration in molarity can expressed by a scale, logarithmic scale. Okay. So, negative log of base 10 of concentration of H plus is the pH. pH is equal to minus log of H plus ion concentration. This is pH. How we can determine a pH? pH is equal to minus logarithm of, but is based on H plus. This is called, it's very famous equation. pH is equal to minus log of H plus ion concentration. This is called that one. Okay. Then tell me, what about the H plus ion concentration? I already mentioned in the last paragraph. What about the H plus ion concentration? Tell me. Experimentally determined by how much? Tell me, Shona. pH. pH we can go into find out. Okay. So pH is equal to minus log of 10 of H plus ion concentration we already mentioned last section. Tell me, what about the H plus ion concentration here? Is a numerical value. Tell me. H plus ion concentration value. Tell me, Shona. How much? In that section, I already told you H plus concentration is equivalent to OH minus concentration. Both are same. Then it is equivalent to a definite value. What about that value, Shona? Check your previous classes. Note and then tell me the reason, the value. Text me. For good? Tell, Shona. Shona, can you hear me? What about H plus ion concentration? Is an experimental value. I already mentioned that, na? Last time. Experimentally, us. Do you know? Don't know, then tell yes or no, at least. Then I can correct you. Okay, that is called what? 1 into 10 to the power minus 7, Anna? You already discussed. Now clear? Is it clear?
We already mentioned it, for finding out the 10 to the power minus 14 equation pay.
Yes. So we can substitute here.
Log 10 into this constant ratio. How much? 10 to the 1 into 10 ratio minus 7 is equal to 10 to the power minus 7. Minus 7 like this. Then can you, how it become? This minus is like this. Then this minus, this is a format is there. And a logarithmic format. How? Log x square is equal to 2 into log x format. This format I'm using here. So this value want to multiply 7 into log 10. So minus into minus 7. 7 log 10. What about the value of log 10? Log 10 is equal to what? Log 10 is equal to what? It's a basic of mathematics. Logarithm. Tell me, log 10 is equal to what, Shaunak? Yes or no? Do you know or don't know? Tell me. You know? Log 10 value. You can use, calculator also you can use right now, but you want to memorize. Log 1, 10 is equal to 1. So apply karo. PH is equal to 7. Log 10 is equal to 1. So 7 into 1 is equal to 7. So PH is equal to 7. This much clear? This much clear? Okay. Clear? Shaunak? Yes. So pH of pure water is, this is 7. Pure water, pH of pure water is equal to 7. Because we are using H plus ion from the water molecule, na? That's why. So pH, mainly concentration of hydrogen ion concentration is determined the pH. So minus log of H plus concentration, we will get to the pH. So minus log of H plus ion, that is 10 to the power minus 7, we will get the pH as 7. With the help of this pH value, and students, with the help of this pH value, we can do something. In our last time, H3O plus concentration is greater than OH minus concentration is an acid. Likewise, acid solution has a acid solution. Now next, look, acid solution have a pH. Acid solution is, we can say represented how acid solution has a pH. Okay. pH is less 7. This is the representation. Acid solution, pH should be less than 7. So basic solution, opposite. Basic solution has a pH greater than 7. And then neutral solution has pH is equal to 7. This also you can note down. Okay. Revise the equation. Understood? Okay. Then again tell me Kw equal to Kw ionic product of water is represented by equation. What is that? Shaunak, Kw is equal to What is that? Kw is equal to
tell me, what about the equation? Kw is equal to? Shavanak? Okay. You are telling like that. But one more thing. Kw is equal to that format is there, right? Concentration of H3O plus into concentration of OH minus. So H plus concentration and OH minus concentration. You are right. 10 to the power minus 7 whole into 10 to the power minus 7. So we will get Kw is equal to 10 to the power 7. 10 to the power minus 14. Very good. 10 to the power minus 14 is Kw. So next, take negative logarithm on both sides of the equation. Okay. What do we want to do? We will get an equation like this. Suppose the answer, we can take a negative logarithm on both sides. What happened? This Kw become minus log Kw. And then this is equal to minus log 10 to the power minus 14. It become like that. Then, okay, this is the thing. Then what do you want to do? Another one more thing, PKW is equal to PH plus POH minus, which is equal to 40. This is also another famous, PKW is equal to PH, not plus, PH plus POH. This is represented by H plus concentration, and this is represented by OH minus concentration. So we will get, if we add that one, we will get 14, like that. Okay, so PKW is a very important quantity. Okay, it is for aqueous solution and control the relative concentration of hydrogen and hydroxyl ion. This PKW will control hydrogen and hydroxyl ion concentration, PKW. Then next, we can see that in our figure, could you see this one, students? Here you can see that there is a color matching thing. Can you see this one, Shana? Is that clear? Clear or not? So here we can see that pH paper with four strip that may have a different color at the same pH. Look, 0, 2, and they're arranged 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. Okay. So here we can see the different pH range. pH 0, 1 color, pH 14 make bright color. Okay. So with the help of this kind of pH paper, we can easily find it out which one is acid, which one is base, according to color change. Okay. So, pH meter is a device that measure the pH-dependent electrical potential test solution. Likewise. So, this one you want to keep it in your mind. That much only. This famous equation keep. Some equation already discussed. Now, we can move on to problem solving. Take a piece of pen and paper in front of you and then we can go through some problems. Okay. 5 minutes we can revise everything. Take time for revision. 5 minutes. Shavanak. Okay. revising shonak aru revising okay okay now we can solve some questions write down the question answer karo very easy the concentration of hydrogen the concentration of hydrogen ion in a sample of soft drink is 3.8 into 10 to the power minus 3 molar what is its ph what is its ph this is the question you want to answer the question understood concentration of hydrogen ion which equation you will use use the equation and tell me the answer easy or not tell me shona easy enough shona any difficulty is it difficult direct substitution yeah then do it I'm waiting for your result okay any confusion I am ready to solve again but try to do log yeah that is a difficult form so do you have a logarithmic sorry scientific calculator do you have calculator okay then I will tell 3.8 log is equal to 0.58 okay That much enough, na? Shana, others remaining you want to solve. So 0.58 log 3.8. I will solve. Log 3.8 is equal to 0.58. Apply. Then tell. Tell me. Do it. Exact answer. Use your normal calculator and then just tell me a result. Yeah, 2.42, right. 2.42 is our answer. Okay. So therefore pH of the soft drink is 2.42. Is it acidic or basic? It is my question. Acid or base? Soft drink is acid or base? pH you find it out. Then tell, is it acid or base? According to the pH range. Tell me. Shana, you got the pH, na? 2.42. That means what? Acid or base? Tell. Acid. Why? Because pH is less than 7, and that's why. Okay, clear? Clear? Okay. Another question. Calculate. pH of a 1×10⁻¹ molar solution of HCl. This is another question. pH of a 1×10⁻¹ molar solution of HCl. How we will find out? Here, Anna. What you wanted to find out? pH of 1×10⁻¹ molar solution of HCl. Here, H plus concentration you want to find out. Okay. Okay, we can solve this one later. Without a scientific calculator, Anna, a little bit difficult. That's why. You know, saturated solution of NaOH pH is around 15. Around 15. Here you can see there is a data. Here you can see a data. Here, saturated solution of NaOH is 15. So then 0.1 molar, 0.1 molar NaOH, na, that is equal to 13. 0.1 molar is NaOH is equal to 13. Lime water is around acid, 10⁵ lime water. Then egg white, sea water, is 7.8. Only the pH. Then human blood is important. Blood. Human blood, na, pH is around 7.4. Human blood, slightly acidic, slightly alkaline, like that. Alkaline nature mainly, 7. For alkaline in nature. Then milk, 6.8. Human saliva, 6.4 is acidic in nature. Then black coffee, 5 pH. Tomato juice, 4.2. Lemon juice, 2. Concentrated HCl is very, very, very high pH. So,
concentrated HCl is 1 and a very lower pH value, so is more acidic is slightly this kind of things are basic in nature. 7 above na 7.4, so basic in nature, human blood. This much clear? Okay. Next, but important. Ionization constant of weak acids. Ionization constant of weak acid. Ionization constant of weak acids. Weak acid. Okay. I already mentioned that, Shaunak. HX is an imaginary acid. Is an acid. It will react with a base H2O. What about the product? Tell me. HX reacted with a H2O, what about the product? Tell me. Conjugated acid base will form, na? What are they? Text me. What are they? Shana, tell me. Touch me. Shaula, can you hear me? Do you know or tell don't know, ma'am? Hello? It is the H3 O++ X minus H3 O++ H minus. Shauna.
again. This is the condition. H3O plus. Then what are that?
Suppose it is a condition. So here, in initially, HF's concentration is represented by C.
Okay. In initially, the HX concentration we can represented by C. Then alpha is another lecture. That is okay.
So initially these are 0, 0. Starting na a reaction is starting time only reactant concentration only. Water will never consider. We will never consider that. So anyway, C 0, 0. After a while.
File, we can see that alpha be the extent of ionization. Another new term you want to study, alpha, that is called a extent of ionization. Change. Change in M. Okay. So how much change will happen?
So that there is a concentration, extent of ionization represented by alpha. There is a decrease in the concentration of C. So this is represented by minus C alpha. Same time here, extent of concentration alpha, here also alpha. So here C, C, because here the concentration become increases.
But here
concentration decreases, here concentration increases, minus C alpha plus C
alpha. Okay. Then equilibrium concentration. Equilibrium concentration, how we can say?
Equilibrium concentration means what? Initially this much. So C minus C alpha. Okay. C minus C alpha.
We can say like that. And then equilibrium concentration C alpha into C alpha.
These are similar. C alpha, C alpha. Here it meaning initial to final. What are the changes? Here only forming C alpha, only C alpha. Clear. This is the condition. So that C is the initial concentration of the undissociated acid HX at a time t equal to 0. Alpha means extent up to which HX is ionized into ions. Okay, that extent they are telling. So can you tell me Ka? Can you tell me Ka? Dissociation constant means, well, Ka equal to what? Product upon reactant. Then tell me, what do you mean by Ka? Can you? K equal to Shanak. Ka is called a dissociation or ionization constant. This Ka is called a dissociation constant. Dissociation constant or ionization constant. Tell me, it upon this one, okay? So C square alpha square upon C minus C alpha, like this, okay? So C as the common term, we can take out. So which is equal to C into C alpha square upon C into 1 minus alpha. C, C get cancelled. So we will get the result C alpha square upon 1 minus alpha. C alpha square upon 1 minus alpha. K is called a dissociation or ionization constant of HX. This much clear? Actually, it can represent, this is also H plus form, na? So H plus upon X minus, concentration H plus upon X minus, this is equal to HX concentration. This is also K equal to, same thing, but we want to change into some extent of dissociation term and all, we will get the thing. This is clear, revise once again the definition and the derivation. In the initial, C is the concentration. After that, here, there is no more product is formed, 0, 0, time t, at a time t equal to 0. Here after that, there is a decrease in, they are represented by minus sign, concentration of C decreases, n extend alpha. So C alpha, C, a new term will form. Again, this equilibrium, at equilibrium condition,
initially and finally there is a change we are conducting. So C minus E alpha, which is equal to C alpha, everything is connected into dissociation constant, that is C squared alpha squared divided by C minus E alpha. So we will get the final result, that is C alpha squared minus alpha, 1 minus alpha. This is very important. If you know the concentration, C is what? Initial concentration they will provide in your question. And then extent of dissociation also will provide. So easily you can find out the degree of dissociation constant. You can find it out with the help of this kind of reaction. Clear? Note down the famous equation. Clear? Okay. Any doubt? Sure enough. Any doubt? Any doubt? Okay. Revise once again. 2 minutes revision. Can I start next one? Shonak? Okay, Shonak, what about tomorrow? You will be there? Due to Pooja and all, na? What about that? You will be there? Sunday and tomorrow. Tell me. Tomorrow Sunday, are you okay? Sunday means puja related anything? That's why I'm asking. What about your opinion? You will be there on class, sharp time. Maybe afternoon, 1:30, 1 o'clock. Any other program or anything? I'm asking personally. Tell me. Not an announced, but you are free, Anna, tomorrow. Are you ready to take my class? That's why I'm asking. Not yet declared, tomorrow is a holiday like that. But I'm asking, are you there? Because today only, you only, na? Others are missing. So I'm asking. If you will be there, I'm ready. Yes, ma'am, in the morning. Okay, morning, I think biology class only, na? Biology class is on morning now. Shonak? Okay. Okay, you can discuss with the sir. Okay, we can discuss later.
formula. Farmer's Famer formula. Look now. Pk is equal to minus log k. K value now we discussed. We add pk like that, you will get minus log k. Pk is equal to minus log k. This one you want to memorize. K is the ionization constant. Like PKW, you already represent na, likewise. Then, tomorrow we want to go through some equation, some problems. Okay, that related to a famous stepwise step approach. With the help of a general stepwise step approach, it can adapt to evaluate the pH of the weak electrolytes. Stepwise step approach. Then with the help of that, we can find out the pH. For example, the ionization constant of HF is 3.2 into 10 to the power minus 4. Suppose ionization constant, that is K. Calculate, you want to calculate the degree of dissociation of HF in a particular concentration and calculate the concentration of all species present in the solution and its pH also. Maybe you can expect it like you want to find out the pH. So tomorrow we can discuss the pH, how we can discuss the pH, how they are related to the equation and to all. Okay, so till that, a lot of reactions and equation we discussed today. Okay, revise once again, and then Ka, finding out Ka is very important. Okay, that alpha extent of dissociation related problem is very, very important. Okay, calculate pH is equal to minus log of H plus ion concentration. So initial concentration for the step-by-step procedure, you want to know initial concentration means what, degree of ionization, equilibrium concentration, everything. Once again, I'm repeating that same thing. This procedure you want to study. Suppose, for example, HF plus H2O reacted to form H3O plus plus F minus. Na? So this procedure you want to able to study before tomorrow class. What is that? HF initially, what about the concentration? C. Initial concentration is C. So H3O plus is 0. F minus is also 0. After that, after a T time, with the help of extent of reaction, that is alpha term you want to add. Na? See. So change, what are the change? This is concentration. After extent of change, what are the changes happening? Minus C alpha. Change in the minus represent the decrease in the concentration of reactant. Here C alpha. Understood? This is the first step. Second step, equilibrium concentration. This is change. This is initial concentration. Then equilibrium concentration. How we will write equilibrium concentration? How we will write? This minus this, C minus C alpha. C minus C alpha, like that format. Okay, C minus C alpha format. Here, 0 minus or minus plus. No, C alpha only. Here also C alpha. This much step is repeating tomorrow's questions. Okay, first of all, initial concentration is Z. That these are 0, 0. Then exchange or change will happen in minus C alpha. Then equilibrium concentration C minus C alpha. Then C alpha only, C alpha. Okay, these things if you are familiar enough, then
your half of the questions become solved. Okay.
So in that question, they will provide C is equal to 0.02 molar. Then what happened? Here is 0.02 instead of C. Here 0.00. Here 0.02 into alpha. Here 0.02 into alpha. Here also 0.02 into alpha. But here 0.02 0.02 minus 0.02 alpha. 0.02 alpha. 0.02 alpha.
Okay. They will provide the concentration in your question. So try to rewrite and then arrange them accordingly. Okay, Shaunak, this much only my today's section. If you are able to solve, tomorrow we can start. Okay, maybe is there any class or that? You can inform, you can call to a sir and then accordingly we can decide tomorrow is there class or not. Okay, thank you so much, Shaunak. Thank you, bye-bye.